Hello everyone, how are you? So this is the final video on my VR series. Today I'm going to talk about lighting, some additional effects like the bubbles and the snow, and my rendering and editing workflow. Here we have a plane on top, and this plane blocks some light. I'm going to hide it. Because the short film is a long tracking shot, the lighting was a bit tricky since I wanted a different look for each underwater scenario. So I decided to use a sunlight with a blue tint as my base light. Cast shadows disabled, another sun with just a touch of blue, and once I had my base, I started adding lights for each scenario. So an area light that only lights the first part of the underwater scenario. Then I have a few spotlights for the second and the third part of the scene. These are the one with the caustics. The world color is important since as it changes throughout the video, it bathes the scene with different tones. I showed how to change the world color using keyframes in my previous video. These spots are a bit bigger. To make the caustics, I just used a couple of notes. I actually have a video where I show how to make the caustics. And not every spot has the exact same values because I wanted them to look a bit different from each other. These values are different. These values are different too. And the fourth scenario is only lit by the two suns I already showed you, and the same goes for the fifth one. Let's see each light in render mode. My sun. These lines are the different sand material. It doesn't have to do with the lighting. My other sun. The area light. My spotlights with the caustics. I want to take a moment to tell you that if you want to support the channel, you can now leave a tip on my Ko-fi profile so I can keep making this type of content. The second part is visually different from the underwater scene. Here the lighting is high and medium key with practical lights in frame to simulate artificial light sources. The lighting is whiter to give a cool and futuristic look. I used a sun as my base. Here are my settings for the sun. No cast shadows to give this idea of an immaculate futuristic light. Inside the warehouse, I have point lights as practical lights. Inside my other room, I use spotlights. These are a bit warmer. And some area lights. And these lights are just for show, they don't have anything. And then we have these fluorescents. These are meshes with an emissive material. And the fluorescents are animated in rows. I just keyframe the strength of each one. Thank you. Then at the end, these walls open up and I just keyframe the x-axis. And behind it, we have a plane with an emissive material. And fade to white in the editing software. In the editing software, I added other effects such as the bubbles at the beginning and the snow, also made in Blender but rendered independently of the rest of the project. For the bubbles, I just copied the camera of the underwater scenario into a new file because the underwater scene was too heavy to also add particles. In fact, you can see the keyframes of the camera movements of the entire animation, but of course I only cared about the beginning where the bubbles were supposed to be. Then I attach a sphere to the camera, and the sphere is the one with the particle system, so the bubbles will follow the camera movement. After some trial and error, these are my particle settings in case you're curious. And of course, the sphere is not visible. And this is the collection I used for the bubbles. I tried different materials, as you can see. But this was my final material. I render these particles in cycles with a transparent background as a PNG sequence. And as for the lighting, you can see there are no lights here. That's because I only used one of Blender's HDRs. Here it is in the world settings. And of course, you can't see it because I rendered with a transparent background, but it is lighting the bubbles. Now the snow. Because this file wasn't as heavy as the first one, I just made the snow particles in the existing file, but I saved it as a new file and I hid everything not particle related. If I unhide this, you can see this is the floor of the snow scene. I just used a plane as the emitter, my render settings, my snowflake collection for my particles, my particle settings, and of course I hit the emitter because who wants a big plane in the middle of the scene? And to give this windy effect, I used some turbulence and wind. As for my lighting, I just use a sunlight with a bit of a cool tone. And no shadows. My snow material. After rendering all of my images, I made a new project in Adobe Premiere with these settings. I used the reframe plugin to make sure the video was centered. This is my project, some logos at the beginning. I'm going to hide each video track and then go one by one. At the top, the bubbles. I imported them as a PNG image sequence. The bubbles have hard light as a blend mode. Then in Photoshop, I made a blue gradient image because I didn't like the way the top of the frame looked like at the beginning of the animation, and I wasn't going to re-render the frames. My main PNG sequence, here it is with and without the gradient image. The color grading made in an adjustment layer. Then I have a mask because I had some problems at the beginning, and that was the way to fix them without rendering the animation again. A few more masks to fix some problems. Because each underwater scene needed different color grading settings, I made an adjustment layer for each scene and I changed the opacity progressively so the color grading of the next scene will appear and the other one disappear. Here I did a mask to make this glitched effect. I imported a video I downloaded with an interference effect and just animated a mask. Another mask with that effect here. For this glitch effect, I downloaded another video and chose Light and Blend as the blend mode. The beginning of the snow scene is a nested sequence, the color grading. And here I have the snow. This is the first frame of this sequence because I wanted the video to remain still a bit longer. The same color grading than the nested sequence and the rest of the PNG sequence. Again, one frame because I wanted the camera to remain still for a couple of more seconds than my original animation. And the hologram, which consists in a video I made in After Effects to get some random letters effect. I used the character offset for that. A PNG frame made in Photoshop, a PNG image made in Photoshop as well. These two images were animated in Premiere, keyframing the scale to make this pop-up effect. Video I downloaded used as an interference overlay. Here is the mask in the interference video, screen as blend mode. I animated the position and the opacity in the interference video. You can see the mask moving. The color grading underneath the hologram. And fade to white. Now for the sound design. I got someone to make original music. These two tracks are the music. Then an underwater sound. Some bubbles sound and the effervescence sounds, other underwater sounds to give the feel of underwater pressure when the camera goes down, the glitch sounds, some wind and blizzard sounds, some ambience, the fluorescent sounds, the holograms sounds that consist in touch sounds, the voice over, the door opening, and my export settings. To recap, I rendered my PNG sequence in a render farm, I rendered the AXR Mistpass sequence in my personal laptop, I did the compositing in Blender and exported as PNG sequence, then I rendered the bubbles as a PNG sequence with a transparent background. For the second scenario, I rendered my PNG sequence in a render farm and I rendered the snow as a PNG sequence with a transparent background. Then I did the random letters effect for the hologram in After Effects and exported as an AVI. I made two PNG images for the hologram in Photoshop, the masks I mentioned earlier in the editing chapter, then in the editing software. I imported all these PNG sequences, I imported the video with the hologram text, and I also imported the two PNGs for the hologram effect, which were animated in Premiere. And additionally, I imported videos I downloaded from YouTube, one for the glitch effect, the interference video I masked, and the other one to add an interference effect to the hologram's image. I imported all the masks. I did the color grading, added the music and the sound effects, and exported as an MP4. If I'd wanted to do everything in one file and render everything in one PNG sequence, the underwater effect, the bubbles, all in the final quality of 3840x1920, I would have needed more time to render everything, and it wouldn't have looked as good because, as I explained, I changed the lighting for the particle settings to look good, for example. So, moral of the story is, plan your strategy. Sometimes taking time for testing things will make you save time in the final run. And if you have a complex animation, maybe splitting things up rather than combining everything into one file will be a better call. And that's it for today's video and for this VR series. I hope you'd enjoy it and dare to make your own 360 degree animation. And if you like my content, you can now support me on Ko-fi. And let me know in the comments below what would you like to see next. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!